We want to move to our next topic and our next speaker, Julia Kordovatova, who will talk a little bit about behavior change and persuasion.
In context.
Hello everyone, my name is Julia. And it's my really first time as a public speaker. And looking for the team for today's speech. I was aimed to form a new positive behavior for myself, to speak louder, slower, not to use such bad words or sounds which might be counted against me. But and I was really into the theme, and that's why I decided to tell you about this tremendous theme, how to motivate yourself to change your or maybe someone else's behaviors. But for the first, let's look on an assumption like, what if you are going to stop yourself like from snacking? What do you tell yourself in that way? Probably the most common way you tell yourself, like, beware, you're going to be fat. That's really tremendous phrase, because it shows like threats and warnings are really common in our daily life, because we use it all the time to motivate ourselves. And it seems like quite reasonable assumption, but when fear induces the action, and it seems like quite reasonable, but science shows that it's not that. It doesn't work in that way. Against it, the positive information has much more effectiveness in our daily life, and it shows the positive ways and positive results in each age groups and remains stability throughout the time. Scientific research shows that there are three key strategies that you might use, that you may use in your daily life. The first thing is social incentives, social sense. It's like about comparison what other people do. We are really social creatures, and all the time we are looking for the others and what they are doing, what they think about us. For example, just to motivate people to pay their taxes on time. In Britain, one way they put the really short sentence in a notification list, like 9 out of 10 British people pay their taxes on time. So that's an example of social incentives. The second key strategies might be immediate rewards. We all care about our future, but future is so far away, and our brain works in that way that we all more likely to get any kind of sure reward now than something unsure in the future. The third thing is sense of control. Our brain really likes to control any kind of processes in our life. And the good example of implementation of all these tremendous steps might be like an example of electricity bill, which was made in Britain, I think. It was aimed, this bill, was aimed to feel good about your efficiency and to motivate your to reduce your electricity usage. The things that they did, that they show the graphs in it. Your exact graph about your electricity usage, the graph which showed the average usage in the neighborhood, which is actually the first step. The immediate reward with smiley faces like, oh, you are doing good, it's quite well. Or the opportunity to get maybe two smiley faces, so you have a positive tendency throughout the maybe half a year. And they had another line, like the most efficient neighbor throughout the neighborhood. And this tremendous thing created like a boom, because everybody throughout this neighborhood would tend to reduce their electricity usage. So, what I'm going to say about, if you're going to create your positive behavior, change your behavior in a positive way, you're really maybe interested to change the way how you're doing this. And it's a good idea to implement some scientific research